world's housing list. It's the same pool of people. So we should be saying to social housing providers, where we're notifying you that somebody's had their benefits stopped, they should be exempt from eviction. Where Lambeth Council is placing people in private accommodation as an alternative to council or social housing, we should be saying, should their benefits be stopped, we will underwrite you at least for you to be able, as a landlord, to be able to cover things like mortgage and insurance and the absolute basics. So maybe we can't cover what you're charging as extra for you to keep in your back pocket or whatever, but we can at least cover the bare minimum to make sure that you as a landlord aren't losing out and you're not having to evict this person because you can't financially manage to keep them on. We should be instituting a good landlord guide, part of which should include that you don't evict except in certain instances. For example, if somebody's damaged the property or is causing distress to other residents. There is no reason we can't institute those things, especially something like a good landlord scheme. There's no reason. There's very little financial implication. It's mostly about making sure that you have that set of criteria that a private landlord agrees to stick to. And then we can provide advertising. There's no reason why we couldn't have a section in Lambeth Talk or on the Lambeth website saying these landlords have signed up to this scheme, and that means you expect a certain standard of behaviour. And that would cover everything, including that could cover things like agreeing to give permission for adaptations to be made. It could include so many things that would help disabled people with housing needs beyond just the issue of being evicted because your universal credit's been stopped or because you've been put into sanctions on your ESA or because PIP is taking forever to transfer you over from DLA or whatever else. There is so much that this council could be doing to be more proactive and more inclusive and more supportive, and it's just been content for far too long to sit down and do nothing.
I've got I've got correct figures. Sorry, it's use of bailiffs rather than eviction, so just very clear. So there were, in 2014, 1,908 cases of bringing in the bailiffs for people in receipt of council tax support, and after that's dropped to zero. However, for non-council tax support, the use of bailiffs in 16-17 was 9,726 uses of bailiffs in 2016-17.
How much is that costing us?
I don't know, but that's my freedom of information request that I just got back. So it's not, I want to be clear, it's important to be clear on these things, use of bailiffs rather than evictions.
Thank you. Okay, well now, question 8. Unless I have nothing.
Oh, to do
with the restrictions, please.
Just about the where I live, the payment for the rubbish bins and all that, because there's rubbish collector when they pick up or they collect the rubbish. They don't put it back to where it was, they just leave it out anywhere there. And it's been going for years. I keep bumping and even for people with a wheelchair, they can't, it's all blocked.
I mean, there are issues like bins are taken out left anywhere in the narrow pavements. I understand the policies that the bin people don't, it's a responsibility in the homeowners to do the bins out. But I think that personally that we're in a situation where the bins are left in the property, leaving the pavement clear. It's bins, it's all things like roadworks that occur where they don't consider people in wheelchairs or people visiting the pavement or a whole range of people not being able to access the pavement. And scaffolding up, hoardings up, all these kinds of things.
Cars
parking, there's a whole range of things. Basically about making our...
And then some shopkeeper who run a coffee shop, they take in all the pavement and they've been in a wall like this. There's nowhere to...
Yeah, absolutely. They're restricting us. We're being excluded from vast areas of the borough and the city and the country where, we're not welcome because we can't negotiate.
No.
So this question will now go on to Jonathan first, please.
So can I just clarify what the question was?
Sorry, the question's about... making our streets more accessible. So there's got to be, we believe that the council needs to renegotiate whatever agreements they have with the rubbish refuse collectors, so that it's the responsibility of the refuse collectors to make sure that they go into the properties, take the refuse from the properties, do what they have to do, and return any receptacles that are carrying the rubbish. So basically, don't wait until someone comes home from work 7 or 8 o'clock at night, and I can't go down Milford Road because it's like a slalom, and I'm sure they're the same situation, and food will have exactly the same situation, probably more perilous, because at least I can see and make that choice not to go, and food doesn't have that choice. So it's about reclaiming the street for people who need clear access and passage.
Yeah, absolutely. So I've had a long-standing interest in this issue, so I actually wrote to the Equality and Human Rights Commission about this. So I wasn't getting a satisfactory response from Lambeth, and asked them to investigate. They said I have to come back to Lambeth and do some more pushing, and I have been. One of those things I uncovered was that they didn't actually carry out an equality impact assessment when the policy was put through to change the bins. That, I think, speaks volumes, because if they had done, they would immediately identify. Now, particularly where there are narrow pavements, it's absolutely impossible to get past. My son, navigating his way to school in a powered wheelchair, he has only sight in one eye, and he has what it's like if you're partially sighted or blind. It's impossible. So I would like to see that policy reversed, absolutely. I think it's also an issue. I was speaking to someone on the doorstep about this just last week. Someone who was disabled, had mobility issues, and of course can't put their bins out. Now, I know that Lambeth say they have a policy that refuse collectors will help people put their bins out if it's brought to Lambeth attention, but we all know in practice that doesn't happen. It's also an issue of the accountability when you contract out services like this. Even as the service is as it is, the bins are supposed to be carefully put out in nice neat rows. And of course, they just get pulled out and stuck in the middle of the pavement, all over. And so it's really impossible to navigate. It is an absolute shambles. And I think it is, if you like, a microcosm of the way the council deals with disabled people. They are an afterthought. And you don't get the attention they deserve. And when these policies are put in place, the full impact and quality impact assessments aren't done. Or if they are done, they're just paid lip service to. So yes, the answer is I'd like to see that policy reversed. I'd also like to see much more attention paid to A boards on pavements up and down our high streets, which no sooner have you got one lot got rid of than they all appear again. I do appreciate the need for businesses to have them out there. I'd like to see alternatives, though, explored for signposting to businesses that do not obstruct the pavement and do not make going down the high road, frankly, a dangerous exercise.
Thanks, John.
Yeah.
Charlie, please, next.
I'm going to slightly disagree with him, saying that people are an afterthought, because that would imply that some thought was given at all. I don't think it is. I honestly don't think it is. The council very kindly replaced all the paving on my street recently. It only took 3 days for us to get a response from them on why they decided to leave a 6-inch drop at the end of our ramp with no access out, because they removed all the paving and didn't put anything in place to bridge the gap so that we could leave the house for 3 days. It's an incredibly, it's very lucky for them that my mum didn't have any medical appointments or anything else to get to, or they'd have been looking at a very nice personal injury claim. It's got to change. So, to go to things like replacing paving, we were given no notification. Lambeth Council is chronically bad at telling people what is going on and what's happening when. It would have been so easy to send out a letter going, we're replacing the paving. If you require any special access or if you have any issues, please contact us, and to have a designated person who is there to deal with disabled people and elderly people who have specific access needs around those issues. The assisted collection, we have assisted collection nominally. Sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't. We ring up and we get told you have to wait a certain number of days And then by the time we ring up, they go, oh, well, the bin's being collected. We've got waste that needs to be disposed of that we can't fit in the bins because assisted collection is rubbish. Ha ha. Sorry.
I got it.
Yeah, no pun intended. That wasn't actually intentional, sorry. Yeah. We should be putting the bin... There's a basic minimum. Put the bins back. As Sean said, it's not right that you're waiting on householders who are out and could be out at work, or you know, if you've got you go to work, you pick the kids up, you take them to the office, and by the time you get back, it's 8 o'clock at night, 9 o'clock at night. That's too long, and it's not their fault that they can't bring their bins in any earlier than that. It should be on the people who are collecting the bins to put the bins back in such a way as they are not impeding access to the pavement for everyone else.
And shut the lids.
In terms of street furniture, we should be looking at where street furniture is positioned. We should be making sure that there are clear access paths. We should be actually saying, getting somebody out there with a flaming tape measure and going, oh, that's not wide enough for a mobility scooter to get past.
Take someone with a mobility scooter.
Take someone with a mobility scooter, you don't even need to. Yeah, well, exactly. You know, when they're deciding about things like if people want to put tables and chairs outside their shop, getting somebody along to make sure that the room there is actually available, marking out the space and going, this is your space. If you go over that space, we'll take the stuff away, we'll revoke your permission. And being a lot more hardcore about street furniture from shops and cafes and businesses. As a, you have this permission, but we will remove it if you aren't using it properly. If we have to keep telling you to move your sign, to move your tables and chairs, we'll revoke the permission. It's not an automatic right. You don't have an automatic right to stick A boards, to stick tables and chairs outside your cafe, outside your off licence, outside your Tesco's or your Sainsbury's or other supermarkets are available. It's about us being out, or about the council being more, it's all of it, it's all the time, the council needs to be more proactive. The council needs to crack down harder and look at things in more detail. And that includes training people like traffic wardens, so they can keep an eye out for this stuff as well. They're wandering around the borough, they'd be perfectly placed to go, oh actually, while I'm wandering around the borough looking at tickets and this, that and the other, oh actually that shop's got its chairs outside the area it's got designated.
Thanks, Charlie.
Multitasking.
Yeah. Thank you. And Jackie, have you final response to this question?
Yes, accessible pavements. I spend quite a lot of time walking up and down the pavements, and certainly from my lesson from walking out with a man with a blind dog, I'm agreeing with a lot of things that people are saying. The thing that my favourite thing I really don't like is those little flower boxes that people put on the street. If you want to put a flower box outside your house, put it on your windowsill and leave the pavement clear. So people like to do these things, they like to put little boxes around the street trees, it's all that to trip hazard. So, and make the road a bit narrow as well. But we're mainly talking about bins.
Bins was like the kettles, if you like. No, it's just every meal is a horizontal checking.
Well, in the last few years, we have lost hundreds of staff. 5-6 years ago, we had street inspectors who walk up and down every street, looking at potholes, block drains, overhanging hedges, all that kind of thing. We don't have people doing that job anymore because we have cut back on that kind of thing. We just don't have the money to pay those sort of people. So it is important that the public do is report on as many of these things as possible. We have got a street champion scheme, and I don't know if any of you have got them in your street, where people who are interested in that kind of thing do the reporting in. They don't fix anything, but they do reporting in. So these all help a little bit, but I agree that the bins is an issue. But see, why do we bring the bins in the first place? Because there was so much rubbish all over the place with the bag system. And the foxes seem to become more and more prolific in our borough. And the bins, at least the bins, keep the foxes slightly hungry because they can't get into most of them. And so that's why people were pleased to have the new, the black bee bins, and then the green ones came in because the recycling was getting torn open by foxes as well, and littered all over the place, which also acts as trip hazards. Bananas, food, it's disgusting stuff you get on your feet. And I've added dog mess into this discussion as well, which is another terrible thing that happens. But we are getting more and more people seem to be responsible dog owners, but there's always one who doesn't, and they're the ones that we're likely to put your foot in, sadly. What do we need to do about this? Well, again, it's coming back. Number one, it's coming back to the awareness, which I'm very hopeful that we will have some program increasing the awareness of all the frontline staff, including the bin men and the refuse people and the street cleaners. And the wider residents, because they think these little flower boxes outside their houses are cute, but actually they can really narrow the payment down. The bins, what do we do about the bins? Assisted collection, if that's patchy, whoever's responsible for bins needs to be told so that they can investigate that. That shouldn't be happening. And street furniture, yes, I think what we need to develop is sometimes call them street guides, design guides, where you just put everything in there so that you put all that stuff in one place. Don't say, we're going to clamp down on tables and chairs, we're going to clamp down on this kind of stuff. We just put it all into one place, and this is how to do it. No A boards. Every cycle hoop is going to have some things in so you make it easy. What are we going to do with all the bikes that get abandoned? The people leave, and then somebody takes the wheel off, and the person who ends up back doesn't want it. Well, when are we going to take them away? We need some clarity about all those things, so we need to work on that. And work on that with disabled people and cyclists and shop owners and people who use the shops. We've got to work together on that.
Jack, the little borders around trees and the planters, that is the council's rescue programme.
This is working, Jonathan.
No.
We have a very important question come now.
We have to be
out by 4:30. Very disrespectful to the last question.
We've got to avoid trip hazards.
Okay, I'm asking now the last question, which is Mariana. Please, could you ask your question for the panel?
Yes.
Thank you.
The question is, charging for social care is a tax on disabled people that is forcing more and more disabled people to go without essential support. Hammersmith and Fulham Council, which is a labour council as well, has stopped this unfair charge. Will you do the same?
Thanks, Marianne. The question is, whoever is in power, will you scrap social care charges? And I'll put that to you, Jackie.
It's a very interesting question, and when I heard about that, I was on to my colleagues over there saying, how do you do it?
Yes.
Because another council, it's the only council in the whole country out of 150
yes.
that can do it.
Yes.
And I don't know how they manage it. They can't really explain it, but they don't seem to have very many clients using social services. That seems to be
Sorry, who works here, she came and spoke about this to us, and she didn't have that impression. But anyway,
when I talked to my colleagues over there, that's what they said. Now, if we were to introduce this unilaterally, without a change in the rules, the funding rules, if the national government comes up, if we get a Labour government and we have a national care scheme, it may well be possible to do this.
Disabled people work together with...
No, Mariana, I've got a blind assembled to you.
It's one council out of 150, and they have a relatively small number of people, clients, compared to us anyway. And it would be great if we could do that, but we would need the money. If we were to introduce no charging, we would have to cut some services to make up for lack of income. So that is always a dilemma we have, isn't it?
So we have
a financial assessment process, which we hope is reasonably fair, and if it's not, we need to look at that.
Now, there's the response now. I'll now put the same question to Charlie. Thank you, Jackie.
Are you in principle? No.
absolutely is a tax on disabled people. No disabled person should be having to pay for care that they need to live a full and independent life insofar as possible. And that may mean that we look at things like having to increase council tax, as much as nobody likes having higher council tax, if it's It may mean that it will be something we have to look into, but it's something where we need to be working with the same people, with social care recipients in the borough, and looking at ways that we can reduce costs, whether that's being more efficient and finding ways we can be more efficient in the way we're providing care, whether that's looking at, like I said, increasing council tax or increasing other taxes, levying taxes on certain groups or certain people, for example, developers, increasing taxes on developers to help meet those costs. But in principle, yeah, we should not be charging for social care. It's an unfair tax on disabled people. It's something that non-disabled people do not have to deal with to live full and independent lives, and nor should we.
Thanks, Charlie. Finally, Charlie.
Marielle, is there anything else you wanted to say? Because I'll give up my time for something else you'd like to say.
Just on this whole issue, the fact is that when universal credit does come in properly, a lot of people who are charged at the moment £60-£70 a week will have their charges cut anyway. So they'll be half because they'll be losing certain benefits. Universal credit is scrapping certain disability premium. So straight away, your income's going to be about half anyway. When it comes to people who fight for self-funders, they are so far from King's Power. Working in this sector for 6.5 years, I have come across two clients coming across my desk who are self-funders. So I see this as something, Amherstville and Fulham can do it. If there's a will there by any government, I think there's a way.
Thank you.
I wouldn't mind having my 3 minutes, but I'd like to just give Marianne a chance.
I would say that if, with what Sean has said, working with the disabled people and also not feeding disabled people what you want them to have. But Hammersmith and Fulham was able to do that with the disabled people, because Hammersmith and Fulham was originally a Tory borough. And if that can happen, it's making the disabled people that they have a stake in the society. And by you telling them what they want and not listening to them, the only problem we have in this borough is that the party that is controlling this one state party have actually taken a voice to say, we know what the disabled people need. But have the disabled people actually said what they need? It's high time now the disabled people in this borough start thinking about themselves, actually making use of your vote and voting. Register and say, we have a need, work with us, and we are willing to work with you.
Right, that's great. So I would add that the principle for me is like the principle around the NHS. And we shouldn't give it up, because you don't know what life is going to throw at you, you don't know what life is going to throw at your family. You cannot base your life on a lottery and a roll of the dice. So social care is absolutely fundamental, that it should be free at the point of use. This is something that we proposed in our 2015 manifesto nationally, something that we reiterate in our 2017 manifesto. There is enough money, the problem is the money is in the wrong hands, and we need to go and get it. This is not an issue that's going to go away. It's going to continue. We get thrown at us the ageing population, but actually it's much more fundamental than that. It's an issue of inequality. But if another council can do it, we would need to see that leadership shown in Lambeth.
That comes to the end of the actual questions here. Now, I want to thank you for taking your time out today.
Thank you.
It's my pleasure. Thank you. I think that's it. We've had some interesting responses. I think we've had a variety of responses. I think I've been a bit honest with their responses. And so I think we also need to thank the panel, our three people, Charlie, Jonathan, and Jackie, for coming, and thank you. And Mr. Ryan, thank you for thank you for your clarity, for your experience and your understanding.
Thank
you.
So
all I've got to say is that all of you, good luck.
Can I just add something to what Mary Ellen said?
Yeah, go.
Don't just register to vote, come and stand. I want to see you here 4 years time, yeah?
Support for years, he's now the co-chair. So, by the way, I should be putting out information on the Payment Disability Forum. I really love all people here. It's a bit dead in the water at the moment.
Yes.
And that is the body, really, the voice of disabled people. If we can get that up and running properly, we can go kicking doors in at the town hall, making our demand. We should be on panels. We should be out there. We should be. It's our voice. The thing that was carried out last year, the consultation, did not have one disabled person in their own right.
I promise you now, if I get elected, you won't have to kick anything down. I'll be there opening the door for you.
Okay, thank you so much, guys. See you later. Oops, sorry.